we doing there, fellas? See if I can get the splitter running again. It appears as though the screws came loose that held the diaphragm in place, causing the diaphragm to get all bent out of shape. Yeah, the diaphragm's all, see it? Just quit working on me, you know? I ordered two kits. Better to have a backup, you know? This is not easy to get to. Not easy at all. I'm gonna have trouble probably getting the screws in. We'll see. We'll see, you know? Hopefully this works. Whenever I pulled the screws out, they almost fell out. I'm surprised it was running up to that point. It is cold, wet, just all sorts of nasty out here today. But I gotta, much better. At least I feel better now. But will it run? That's the question. Only one way to find out, right? Not a good sign. Not a good sign at all. Definitely got more issues. So, when I pulled this off, these screws, They were hard to even figure tight. So I wonder if I'm just leaking air. It's kind of interesting. You probably can't see. It's in a twist. To twist the fuel, get it moving. Kind of interesting. So I'll just tighten these screws up. That's the only thing I can see that might be. Well, there it is. Let's see what happens. Cross your fingers. Sounds better. don't have any spray lube with me. I'll try a little two-stroke oil. Again. This isn't looking good. Not at all. I might be taking the carburetor home. I wonder if there's water in the gas. I wonder. This could be a fuel issue. How do I get it out? Yeah, and more I think of it, it ran fine for the first tank. Then I refueled it, and it wouldn't run after that. There's a good chance this is just bad gas. Water. There's water in the tank, for certain. All right, let's give her another whirl. There we go. That took 58 minutes and 50 seconds to get to this point.